What up, it's your boy Mark. Sorry. I just did Eminem Business off the Eminem Show. Personally, my favorite Eminem album. And I said I was going to come with you with the next song, but I'm going to skip Cleaning Out My Closet because honestly, it wasn't one of my favorites. And Eminem said clearly on Marshall Mathers LP 2 that he doesn't play it in concerts anymore. That he cringes when he hears it on the radio. So I'm not going to disrespect him by doing it. So, but Square Dance is one of my favorites. And it's got to be one of M's favorites too, because I've been to a few of his concerts. And he opens with this, like, it's usually like second, third song into the concert. All right, let's get to it. Another classic Trey beat. Definitely Trey beat. Shit was catchy. I just wanted to pause real quick right there because I hate now when he did that Trump cipher and people are saying, why is he getting all political all of a sudden? And it's like all of a sudden this was 2002, maybe 2003. He's always been political. He just liked Obama, so you didn't hear him talk political for 8 years. But yeah, he always been. And then Bill Clinton, his first two albums, he would just clown, make jokes about, but not, there was no hate to Clinton. But Bush, he hated, and boy does he hate Trump. Pull off his leash, all this peace talk can cease. All these people I had to leave in limbo. I'm back now, come to release this info. I'll be brief and let me just keep shit simple. Can a bitch don't want no beef with Slim? No! Not even on my radar. So won't you please jump off my dick, lay off and stay off. And follow me as I put these crayons to chaos. From sales to sales. Okay, I don't know how much you guys know about the cannabis M&M beef. That was years ago. Makes me feel old. But the story goes, before M&M was big, before his first album came out, he was kind of a fan of cannabises. Cannabis had already dropped his first album. It was a big success. I liked it. And I guess they ran into each other. And M&M went up to Cannabis and was like, hey, we should do a collaboration sometime. I guess Cannabis kind of gave him the cold shoulder and basically said in so many words, like, get back to me when you're bigger, you know. And then Cannabis' second CD came out, bombed. Eminem's CD came out, did really good. And then he did the Marshall Mathers LP only 1 year later. And then Cannabis goes and does Stand 2 without any, without even asking and telling Eminem about it. And a lot of people tried to resurrect Stan. He's at the ball in the river, guys. Sorry, we can't get him back. Open the plastic and then you stand back gasping. He said a whole lot that it's true, how Terror America getting drafted, that taking their babies at 18, he's 28, they're going to take you before they take me. And that's true. 18, you're not even old enough to drink yet, but you're old enough to be given a gun and go to war. 18, I was just a kid. I can't imagine going to war. If they ever do reinstate the draft for some reason, I hope they raise it to at least 21. But he said a whole lot of true stuff there. And that's not political. That's just real talk. Draft, this is facts. But back to the music. I don't know if that was a shot at Nas. Nas had a song that went Uchi Walla Walla, and it was a really weird chorus. Like, it was catchy, just like Eminem's catchy. I don't know if that was a slight diss, or I'm not sure. Him and Nas haven't got along great, but Eminem said so many times that he has Nas in his, like, top five. To me, keep making new shit, produce hits to break the monotony. What's gotten into me? Drugs, rock, and Hennessy. Look like I'm back on my enemies. On your knees, got you under siege. Somebody you would give a lung to be. Hungry like a fucking younger me. Fuck the fee, I can get you dumped for free. Yeah, buddy, laugh is funny. I have the money to have you killed by somebody who has nothing. I'm past bluffing, past the KY. Get ready for some intense, serious ass fucking. Is it wants to, so you know, shout out people he likes. So he said Cannabis won't square it to me. One of my all-time favorite Eminem songs. I hope you enjoy this video, because I really enjoy going back and listening to my favorites. It's been so long since I've listened to these songs, and I hope you liked it. I had fun making that one.